Hello, seafaring tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Ogre Battle with me, BlueAnkylo. So, last episode, we covered the Dalmud Desert, and we mostly fought ninjas and other evil nighttime sort of creatures. Not like undead demons, but generally low alignment stuff. In the next map, I happen to remember that we'll be mostly fighting good type alignment units. So if you're trying to keep, say, a gold dragon at high alignment or an angel at high alignment, this might not be the right map for them. So we're going to be using mostly evil creatures, or at least units that it doesn't really matter if they drop a little bit of alignment. I don't think they're going to be low level, but they'll still be harder to kill. I am going to do one little thing first, though. I probably could have done this at the end of last episode, but I just didn't get to it. I just ended the episode. If you remember, we picked up an orb of Dune or something. We can look at it quick. And this was, in fact, wherever it is, the Dune gem. There it is. Gem of Dune, ruby size of a walnut, one of the jewels of Falana. It's pretty important, but this is the thing that the dude way back here in Pogrom Forest asked us for a long, long, long time ago. I wouldn't blame you if you've completely forgotten about it. But yeah, we can bring it back. And we should get us a message here. Oh, you've brought me the Gem of Dune! Please keep it, and also take this old orb! Take these two gems to the witch Teru in the town of Remoto on the Ryhan Sea. If you take these to Teru, a whole new door will be opened to your life. May the gods walk with you. So, if you remember, there was three mystical gems part of the treasure. We now have two jewels of Falana. So, there you go. It's possible the third one's in the Ryhan Sea. Although, I suppose, you know, there might be some new dialogue if we go back and let, I always forget their crazy names. But if we let the guy know that we delivered the gem, it's possible this guy would say something else. Remember, the guy that gave us, we gave him the Quicksilver, and then he gave us the Gem of Dune. And the guy that gave us the Quicksilver gave us the Olden Orb. Then we'll just speedily travel it up here. Did you need something? Why, yes, we need some of your time. What did you need to know? So we can get a little bit more information, possibly. Let's hear about the 12 white mages. They were the 12 mages who fought with the three High Knights in the Ogre battle. They were able to turn the power of love into magic. White magicians. Aww. They managed to destroy the demons and return them to the underworld. After that, they traveled the land, speaking the teachings of the gods to the people. Currently, the Roshian temples cover this continent, but all of their teachings are based on those of the 12 white mages. They started basically the religion of the world. But wait, there's more! Let's learn about the Zodiac Stones. Even though they use the white magic, they carry incredible destructive power. If that power is misused, it could mean the end of the earth. So the power of each of the 12 white mages was preserved in 12 stones. After the 12 mages died, the stones were hidden, until one who truly follows the gods again would reappear. These stones contain the essence of each of the 12 white mages, and are called the Zodiac Stones. The time may have come to use their power, but a true hero must appear first. We're trying, guys. We're trying to convince them that we're a true hero. And we need some more. Where are they? No one knows where the stones are now kept, but that doesn't mean they can't be found. You must meet the Goddess of Justice, Falana, and receive the Tablet of Yeru. If you, Blue, are a true hero, then you may use that tablet to guide you. And if you remember, we went to visit her before, and she said something about the three mystic treasures of the, whatever they're called. I keep forgetting all the names here, but there's lots of long words. The three Jewels of Falana. Well, we need to make sure we've got all three of those. Then we'll go back to talk to Falana. Then we can go find all the 12 Zodiac Stones. Then we can beat the game and kill the demons, ogres, whatever. Anyway, let's get on with it. To the final paradise. The 24th map, wowzers. Oh, it's one of the musics I like. Woo! I like most of them, but it's better than the whistly flying music. So, there's definitely some water. Not a lot in the center of the map. I should probably pause it while I'm looking around. Lots of cities on the north end. A fair number on the south end, too. Trying to decide how I want to use my watery dragon units, because they are pretty good at moving through water. I mean, I can... I'm looking for a good place to draw an early line. I don't know... Because well, you know, we don't have to rush it, but at this point in the game, we're pretty overpowered most of the time. It would be nice to just put units up in, like, this city and... either maybe this one, I guess. But that's gonna take a bit of work. So, I guess we'll just head to the ones on the south half of the map first, and then we'll just figure it out from there. Now, I didn't spend a very good time. I kind of forgot. I was gonna look at, like, levels for my various characters. Kid, obviously, can still use some more levels up. His unit hasn't been doing terribly well lately, though. Maybe I'll just stop worrying about levels and use all the evil... No, I can't forget, because, like, they're not all finished promoting up. I need to be careful with the Fire Dragon's alignment, and I need to be careful with the Gold Dragon's alignment. So I'm probably not going to use Riddle and Fogle right now, so skip those two. I want to use Eric and Geist. I'll probably want to use Indy again. Lots of evil units out there. Vanilla! Oh, they're pretty overleveled already, too. So we got 1, 2, 3, we can send Saradin, that's 4. I'm not sure if this is a great map for Phantom, they'll probably have lots of clerics. But we got 4 evil units, Geist, Eric, Saradin, Indy. I have to be careful with Yushi's alignment. She needs like, I think it's just like 1 or 2 more levels up, and then I can promote her to her final class. Okay. Who else am I going to use then? I could use Aisha. I'll probably use Aisha. I'll use the 2 zombie dragon units. And we'll still need some good ones. So I guess, like, Badum. Maybe Scarlet. No, Scarlet got lots of XP last fight. So Badum and maybe Guy. Alright, well, I've got a bit of an idea who I want to use. Didn't write it down like I've often done. Alright, so we'll send Kid again. I know he hasn't been amazing, but we need someone that can at least liberate these places. And we'll also send... who did I think? Scarlet? No, Scarlet was pretty good leveled. They got lots of XP. Well, we'll send Saradin along, because he was going to be one of my evil guys. I remember his name. And we'll send Aisha. It's going to take her a while to get anywhere. The fastest is probably just to send her straight to this river, and then just use the river to get to the ocean. We were going to use definitely Eric and Geist. So I will send one kind of each way. That gives me 2 evils on the left, 1 evils on the right. Probably want someone in the middle, to be honest, as well. Just in case they send, like, flyers straight at me, which is pretty likely. Indy is pretty powerful. We'll send him up the middle for now. Maybe he can guard the river at some point. It'll probably take him 1.5 years to get there. Badum, I think I was going to use. So we'll have Badum also cover the middle for daytime in the mountains. And then I need someone to liberate on the right side. Wasn't going to use... Not Nor, not Fogle, not Riddle, probably not Phantom. Running out of people to liberate. I guess Deneb's okay. It's not like It's not a truly high alignment unit, but it'll probably be fine for this. Alright, that leaves me like one more unit I can use for emergencies, I think. It's gonna take Aisha a really long time to get anywhere, but hopefully this works out. Anyway, let's just speed it along a little bit. It might have been another one of those occasions where it's faster to just fly up and then use a 20,000 leagues boots to just, actually, no, on her way over, this won't add too much time. Instead of that, we'll just liberate this again on the way over. Alright, Eric, taking a rest. Babelts. Babaroo. See what we get? We get good card! You're welcome, people! Rejoice! The High Monk Randalls is rumored to be the biggest coward in the Empire. I wonder if High Monk Randalls lives in the castle for this land. Alright, so we'll put people into the city. I don't think I'm gonna push over that big... It's not really a river, but that... whatever you would call that... passage of seawater. I don't think we're gonna cross across that until we fought at least one wave off. You've liberated Pulot! Pull of Watt. There is a ton of buried stuff on this island, on this map too. So I should spend some time looking around for buried treasure, but might do that after the main battle. Like usual, like what we normally do. Okay, we got enough cards again. The ruler of this land, Randalls, has ruined the temples here. He declares a tax for the blessing of the gods. A tax for a tribute to the gods. We all know that he is using that money to stuff his own face. What a terrible guy. Okay. Everyone's getting into position. This is Indy's chance again. I think he's supposed to be going up towards that middle area, isn't he? Alright. Okay, yeah, there we go. So, like I kind of predicted, we've got angels and stuff. Actually, cherubim. See, this is totally cheating. I can't get cherubims until, I believe, level 22, and they're already here at level 20. I bet you in the original game, the promotion tier was 20, and they just upgraded it for the balance patch I'm using. This is a very white magic heavy group. Very, very, very. I think Badam will be okay, but that's a bit crazy. Pull back a little bit, make sure we fight in the mountains. Alright, Badam. Hopefully your white elemental resistance manages. Because this one's gonna hurt. There's gonna be an awful lot of white AoEs. Yeah, my princess isn't gonna do a whole lot here. I expect the Titan will still do a ton of damage. So, the trouble here, of course, is killing these enemy units is pretty bad for our alignment. So we'll have to be careful. But I think we'll get a full wipe here with a little bit of luck. Wait, no, cherubims are not the final promotion. Never mind, I had the names wrong again. That angel would have been doing a different attack if it was at its final promotion. Lots of experience anyway. They must be a pretty good level. Don't think anyone lost any alignment on that fight, at least, so that's a good start. Okay, what's next? More flyers? Wyverns and a muse. Alright. Nothing too crazy. Just fight it out. Okay? Just fight it out. That's what you tell the kids at school. Just fight it out, it's fine. That's not very good. 27 damage from the type. I wonder what weapon he's using that does so little damage to wyverns. Maybe like fire? I think they resist fire pretty well. Actually want to switch to weak here. I don't want him to accidentally kill the muse. Now it's fine. Man, groups with princesses are overpowered. I love it. Alright, are they just all gonna come through that middle room? Middle area? Alright. Chariot card. Very powerful Krakens. This area is covered with beautiful spots, and is known as the last paradise in the Empire. Alright, well they seem to really like coming through this middle bit, so I'm gonna try to get my couple watery units to sort of cover it. Alright, this is a lot of stuff coming at us now in nighttime. So they've got some phantoms as well, some evil units to go along with the good units. This would be the wrong unit to try to deal with that. So we're gonna pull out of the way and let that ghost unit attack first. Or that one's the ghost unit's gonna be dealt with by Batum, and then I will try to pull Indy in the direction, Indy direction that will help. Okay, Kid, you're gonna move back a little bit. It is time for the vampires to show their stuff. And we've got Saradin around for emergencies. Oh, he's marched too, to be honest. Send him over this way. Actually, you know, while it's nighttime, I want to get more stuff liberated, and I don't have a lot of good units down, so I might as well send them back and cover that. I think we'll be safe enough. Yeah, I don't want to have to... Yeah, this'll be fine, it'll be fine. Alright. Okay, time to move. Pincher attack. That was incorrect. Pincher attack, go! Alright, Batum. Kill that ghost. We want to focus on sort of the leader, essentially. Oh, I forgot I was going to check my Titan's weapon. Make sure it's a fire weapon. Well, find out if it is a fire... Like, you know what I mean. I was wondering why he did so little damage to the Wyverns earlier, so... Ooh! Good thing that Princess got some dodges in there. Those guys were definitely hard hitters. Wowzers. Yeah, you shouldn't be fighting during the night much there, Batum. Alright, so the weapon... It's a Bullius Axe, so that's the ice... Pretty sure that's an ice axe. Wonder why that did so little damage to those Wyvern. I don't think they're strong to ice. Alright, Eric. Bunch of birds for you to kill. I'm sure you won't mind. Heh. Nice try, bird brain. As far as I could tell, I could not figure out if Evil Ring causes a status effect. With that exclamation point, question mark point. In the original game, vampires have a life suck in the front row and a charm attack in the back row. Evil Ring is just used by Garry's and I believe some of the Black Dragons. So, oh come on, one hit away. like, vampires don't normally have it, and I couldn't find out for sure if that, you know, the double exclamation point actually means anything. I should have double-checked what we were fighting here before I just let them fight. This'll be fine. Probably should have put the Dark Knight in the back row again, but it should be okay for this fight. Of course, he may just die. But yeah, the magic attack would have been more useful there. The fireball from the back row. Neutral encounter as well. Boy. Oh, just a little mermaid. Well, you can kill the little mermaid. Well, you can try. She might kill you first. There you go. No more Little Mermaids. Okay, what level does that put Indy at?
Peter North moves 19. To your general channel.
I think we need one more. Just a second. Apparently I left something open that I shouldn't have left open. That is a Mumble server, man. Really professional here, guys. All right. And you got to see my desktop again. Man, I got to fix that. All right, so where were we? Besides interruptions due to poor planning, let's heal these guys up maybe. Well, they seem...
Write it out.
The ones I thought were going to fight sort of seem to be running away from them. It does appear that sorceresses really don't gain very much HP on level up. Like, 152 is one of the lowest I've seen. Okay, we've liberated Harmhella. What kind of name is that? Ah, it's the place of love! Harmhella, the city of love. Have you heard of the High Monk Randalls? He takes advantage of people's weakness of religion to make himself rich. It's said that only those who believe are saved. This Randall guy does sound a little sketchy, I'll admit it. Alright, so over on this side, we got some gold dragons. And that group will be no problem at all. You guys want to go against Saradin? Bring it! And, yeah, we'll liberate that city. You know, it's gonna take Aisha so long to get there. Maybe I'll just have her liberate this city on the island first, on her way. I am worried about Indy's unit, so let's throw in some heals. If I can get my way, Indy will get one more level up on this map, and then you'll finally be able to see the class that I've been trying to get with him all along. This is probably going to hurt a lot. Saradin will be fine, don't worry about him. I don't care if you're paladins or not, you're not killing my zombie dragon. Yeah, see? That's not gonna work, guys. You're all dead. You're all washed up. Hey, a Stone of Dragos, just in case you want some more Dragon Masters. Don't worry, Riddle, you'll get your shot again one of these days. This fight will probably be a little bit more challenging. The fact that they've got a healer is going to be a little bit annoying. Actually, they're really not going to have a healer for long, are they? Okay, well, we should be able to do enough damage to finish these if my Lich and my Sorceress don't mess this up. Alright, good work for not messing it up. That could be a pretty difficult fight. Definitely could see that one being trouble. Alright, Indy, well, they're gonna get two AoEs on you that's gonna hurt. If they try to focus down Thunder, they'll be able to kill him. If they try to focus down Indy, they'll be able to kill him. I think in this situation, it's going to be more useful to get the dragon to do an AoE. And hopefully with that, we can get a kill off before too many big hits go in. I don't know, this is not a great matchup. The only good thing is it's the middle of night, so we should be a little bit more powered up than they are. But we'll see. Yeah, they go first no matter what, and they do a lot of damage. Okay, good dodge there, Thunder. Dodge again! Yeah, good work, buddy. Alright, the dragon gets like three of those. We'll get two of those from the Lich. Okay, as long as we can hold out a little bit longer, we got it. We got it! Oh boy! That was a difficult group for Indy. Okay, please tell me that I got the numbers right. Here we go! Devil time. So, the final promotion for the Imp tier gets Meteor! Let's see if it's as amazing as I hope it is. Alright, we've got probably a mountain unit. Yeah. Hmm. Tell you what, we'll send Geist over to deal with that before the night's over. I was planning to have Geist and Eric get all kinds of XP this fight, and everybody's just coming through the middle, basically. Alright, we liberated Gafelt. Good work. Hey, make sure everyone loves me. We've got the City of Love, we've got the City of Temperance. Have you heard about the witch Teru who lives in Ramado? Someone mentioned that, I think. She keeps saying that she comes from the sky. Oh boy, why is it auto-scrolling? The ogre battle is coming again. Please, you want to stay away from not cases like that. Please, I don't know. That I've never seen that happen before. That was weird. Oh, this is the shop as well, by the way. Got lots of all of these, so no worries. Alright, well, gee whiz. Try to send Geist out to help. Way too slow, didn't catch the guy anyway, and now it'll be daytime. Alright. Liberated Ramado. Oh, well, that's where Ramado is. Tomato, tomato, Ramado, Ramado. Good, bad? Bad. Can't win them all. A witch named Teru lives in this town. She's said to be over 100 years old. With all those wrinkles, I'm not surprised. There's a little bit of deep water. It would be even better for them. Alright, Indy. What have you got this time? This is fire dragons and a monk. Alright, well... this is kind of an annoying map in the sense that all of the enemy units are coming straight down the middle where there's no real towns to defend. So, like, what I maybe... well, I could have tried just leaving a bunch of units down here to defend, but it would have been very difficult to liberate the side stuff and keep the enemy contained without them... as much as it hasn't really happened during this recording, like, during the Let's Play, the enemy are pretty good at stealing cities from behind you if they can get to them. So, you know... just guarding your own base probably is not the best strategy. Also, are you just trying to bypass Batum here? Just in case. Alright, Indy. Write it out. See if you can do this. It's just red dragons. I probably should have moved them around. There's your meteor. I should have shown it in normal speed. 24 damage. Well, Indy looks cool and kind of eviler now, not just red. Oh, we're just getting it wrecked. They'll heal up all the damage we do, and we'll barely net any positive gain here. We're actually just gonna retreat, because they're probably gonna kill my lich. So unfortunately, devils kind of like ninjas aren't very good, even though Meteor sounds awesome. I'll try to remember to play that one in normal speed the next time I use them. I forgot. Accidentally sped right through it. Alright, let's see how Batum does against it's the Titans, right? Yeah. Not leader, we want to focus on the strong. Yeah, they're probably pretty strong against white and lightning. So we'll almost certainly kill the leader of this group before we can kill all of them. I mean, there's really no chance. Maybe we can kill... see if we can kill both of those? I don't know. It's a pretty good Titan battle, though. At least we get lots of attacks. Alright, we got two of them down. At least we got some XP, that was fine. Now I think... I don't even want Batum to get too many more levels up, to be honest. Level 22 is pretty acceptable for this phase where we're fighting level 19s. We're already getting that. Okay. Maybe Geist... oh, but it's... okay. If Geist... yeah, okay, I'm gonna do this. I'm sure I've mentioned it before, but... during the daytime, anyone with coffins in their group moves really, really slowly. So I want to have a chance to intercept this guy, so we're going to need Geist to move. I'm also just going to send Eric up, because, I'm tired of these fools. Don't really want him to liberate it, but... I got lots of potions, we'll be okay. Vorai? What was that? What kind of name of that is that? Alright, Hermit's acceptable. Oh, I don't need any tarot cards, that's fine. I heard that even though Randall's is a man of the temples, he is studying necromancy. What? If that's true, he could damage the reputation of all temples on the continent. Well, maybe. Buried treasure?
Find out?
You got a cookie staff. It's a cookie cutter staff. So what was the name of this crazy city? Urai. U-or-a-ai. It's the robot city. It's where Skynet was developed. Alright. I'm gonna start sending people up north. Because I'm tired of defending in the middle on the river anyway. Alright, Geist, you did manage to catch him. Good. Good, good. Excellent. I need, like, Slovakian or something. Transylvanian accent for my vampires. Alright, so this is the red dragon one. Well, now that it's proper night, Indy might do a little bit better. But I am going to send Geist sort of this way. So that the XP gets shared a little bit. And it doesn't seem like the right side is getting attacked anyway. It should be okay. You liberated a Yoshi temple! Oh, well, that will do nothing. A death armor! Well, that's pointless. Randall's is an embarrassment to the name of the temples. He declares a tax for the blessing of the gods, tax for the tribute of the gods. Every time he opens his mouth, it's money, money, money. He acts like a merchant. Now, I talk about money fairly often, too, but, I don't claim to be a monk or anything. I need to pay the troops. Alright, Indy, let's see if you can handle this a little bit better, as it is proper midnight. Should have still considered moving people around a bit. Oh, I sped through it again. Ah, well, you get the gist, though. It would seem that we're doing more damage and taking less in return. So there is that. So in case you're wondering, Meteor will be a black attack, a black elemental, a black magic attack. It should use his intelligence, the way I understand it, and do just one AoE black damage. Coming straight for you. They probably figure their wyverns will be able to kill the Lich, actually. They think they're going to focus him down, so they're trying to chase him. So, the last time we did this fight, for whatever reason, my Duke here didn't seem to do, like, any damage. Do I have any other elemental weapons just sitting around, ready to go here? Yeah, we can switch to fire or ice. I think those things are supposed to be weak to thunder. He loses some strength, but it might be the right element. And to be honest, in this battle, I would rather have more single target than AoE. All right. Fighting it out. So, yeah, focus on strong. See how this goes. My dragon is tough. That's gonna hurt. That's nothing. There's your meteor. That was a little bit better today. Not a ton of damage, but that's kind of what I wanted it to do. I guess 34 was more than last time. Although, I mean, if the Lich is choosing ice, they're probably weakest to ice. It's generally how it works. So the Thunder Spear may have been a mistake. Oh, come on. Just kill it. Thank you. Thank you, dragon. Alright. They seem to really want to go after this guy. I will want AoE against those bird people. I'm gonna start sending people across. Hey, what is going on over here? How are we missing all of these enemy groups? Aisha, she's my water girl. Alright, probably rather her guard at the crossing than the sort of bay over there. Alright, now it doesn't look like he's going after, he's trying to skirt. Alright, well don't let him just sneak by. We don't want any flyer units getting through our guard. Alright, well, Eric, hey. You can handle it. I have faith in you. This is gonna be tough. This is gonna be another one where it's easy to kill the leader and very difficult to kill all of our dragons. On the other hand, they can't do too much to us, so there's that. Lucky there. Would have killed the leader if it weren't for that good timed dodge. Well, I don't think we've done a ton of damage to them, but, you know, something. And then Sarah gets the bounce. I guess actually killing the leader would have been fine there because we would have got the proper bounce. Maybe we just go for a week here and try to kill the leader after all. Oh, 1 HP. I thought they were going to get their heal off. But yeah, this will be fine. This is the last unit that needs that undead staff. Alright, Indy, are you ready? You should be ready. I have faith in you, Indy. You can do it. You can do it! Alright. He has reasonable physical resistance. He's got reasonable lightning resistance. And he managed to dodge the inferno. Okay. And the birds did not dodge the meteor. Nor did they dodge the acid burn. Twice. Okay, I think we got this one in the bag. Unless they managed to kill my leader. Good. The demons should have the best resistance to fire, if I remember it. Fire and darkness would be their strongest stat. Resistances. Alright. Definitely got a win. This group isn't my best. You just gotta accept that some groups are stronger than others. Evil ones and devils just aren't that amazing, even when they're backed up by amazing liches and zombie dragons. It's just the way the game works. Alright, Geist is almost across. The Liberators are slowly moving up. I'm gonna send Saradin kind of up through the water, because he'll move pretty quick through that. And I'm just gonna leave Eric for now in this forest. Okay, it looks like Aisha will probably be able to catch this guy crossing. Alright, Geist, hopefully this counts as land and you'll have proper stats. It does! Alright, well, this should be in the bag. As tough as red dragons are, I don't think they're going to be much of a match for us. Of course, if they dodge all of the evil rings, and if they were able to focus down my sorceress. They're gonna get away, aren't they? We're not gonna be able to finish them off. We're gonna use an Emperor card. That'll give all of my dudes one extra attack. Should be enough. Got a little bit lucky there that she dodged. But yeah, I think we needed the extra couple attacks to get this through. There you go. I just didn't want those ones to run away and, you know, lengthen the episode even more than it is. Alright, Saradin should be fine against, I assume, the Titan group again. Yeah, switch to strong. The Beastmaster will get destroyed no matter what. Ooh, boy, that mage is... He might die, actually, if we don't kill that Titan off before it gets another attack. Quick! Quick, zombie dragon! Okay, good dodge. Everything worked out. And Aisha is now fighting... Yeah, should be fine. Should have enough AoEs to deal with them. Unfortunately, we didn't get the water battle, oddly, but... I think we'll be alright. You know, I mean, the Kraken is surprisingly tanky, as it turns out. I do remember in the lower levels, and especially in the vanilla mod, like, unmodded game file, the Kraken seems to miss all the time, so they may have changed something about that for this patch. But I am used to Krakens being nearly useless. They just... You get four attacks and they just miss three or four of them every time. But that was fine? Alright, what's going on here? Are you, like, running away? You know you don't want to fight all that magic? Ghosts. So who can kill them? Someone needs to have, like, a... I don't think the relic counts as a white weapon. We should probably wait before we push any more forward until we are able to liberate those two cities that I've sent some people towards. It's just gonna take a little bit more time, that's all. Alright, well, I'll tell you what. I know we picked up a Mystic Staff. So we'll just give that to one of the werewolves for now. And I'll just switch it back to nighttime once they're in battle. Because you can do magic tricks like this! Super cheap! You thought it was day and you had a chance! No! Strong is correct. Wait, miss? You got a Mystic Staff on! Don't be like that. Come on, Tiger Man, don't you miss. What? Two? There we go. That was surprisingly difficult to kill that phantom. Starting to get worried. Alright, so it looks like that angel is trying to steal my city. That's what it looks like. Try to intercept. Probably have to use another heal potion, though. How are you doing? Oh, they're gonna kill the sorceress if I don't. If I'm not careful here. Yeah, I mean, this is just a map where I feel like unless you really just turtle up and really wait a very long time, you're gonna have to accept you're gonna need to use some potions on this map because you're gonna have to fight in this middle area where there's nowhere to regenerate. Unless, well, I mean, you could bring all of your good units that have shamans and monks. But then you risk losing all of that alignment and wrecking up your promotions and your composition a little bit. This is a map where you're designed to use evil units to kill the good units. It's just there's nowhere for them. No easy way for them to heal up, unfortunately. Alright, and I think I said, yeah, you definitely need some heals. At least we can do this pretty quickly so it doesn't take up too much episode. I'm gonna give them the full heal, though. Because this group we're up against is gonna hurt a lot. So much white magic. Alright, guys. Looks like you're even fighting in... I guess the river, technically, but oof. Oof, that's a lot of hits. Well, the meteor was good, at least. Good work, Indy. That was better than last time. I have a feeling Duke is gonna die. Yeah. Revenge! That was a pretty effective revenge. Alright, well, sorry, Duke. You're not really that great. I don't think he's a name. I can say that because he's not one of my YouTube people. He's just some random name the game gave him. I guess there aren't really any hero naturally ninja or dark knights or anything. You could turn one of your beast men, and maybe I should have done that with like Leon and there's a couple like beast men, beast masters you recruit or you can buy. And I guess maybe I could have turned them into like ninjas or something, but as you can see, I don't think those classes are really worth their time. I'm gonna send you up this way. So this is Saradin, right? I don't mind Saradin getting a little bit more kills. And I'm just gonna move Eric over a little bit, so he might have a better chance of catching them. Probably should have healed there, that was a mistake. I knew that he had a weakened mage, and I didn't. So they might just kill that mage off if I'm not... Well, if I'm unlucky. We'll do a lot of damage. Oh good, you're gonna focus on the Lich, you fool! Alright, now we need to do enough damage to wipe these guys out. Yeah, we're fine. Success! Saradin, you're a boss! Liberated Salam! It's not quite Salem, or else this would be the Witch Trials. Hierophant, that's acceptable. If he is called the High Monk, then Randall should be a member of the temples. But no one has ever seen him in meditation even once. What a jerk. Start heading up towards that city. And what have we got? Golems. I guess I should heal up here. Make sure whoever our final mage is doesn't just die. Who is this guy anyway? Xavier! I'm sorry you're the last not lich mage. Maybe we'll find you an undead staff and one of these days and you can join up with all of the superpowers. Alright, looks like you caught him. This is not a good matchup for them. Their golems will go down very quickly to magic. Yep. That was a no surprise, or no brainer, no surprise. And Eric, I didn't heal him, but I think he's in good shape. He should be okay for this. Not as much damage as I would like, but they're still a pretty good group. This is probably my favorite of my new units for this Let's Play, this campaign, the ones where I was trying new stuff out. Of all the various compositions we've tried out, this is the one I like the most. I still don't think it's as strong as some of my defaults, my old faithfuls. But of the new ones, this is definitely my favorite. The vampire-werewolf combo is pretty good. And they're not even all that high of a level. Now, unfortunately, that guy's gonna get away. There's just no stopping him. See, if I was smart, I would just do this after the battle so I knew who needed healing, instead of waiting for the next battle to start. Alright, Saradin is in probably acceptable shape to kill some birds. There's a lot of units on this map, a lot of enemy units to kill. Now, being in the water is probably less useful for us, because the birds, oh, they're gonna kill. No! Xavier! I was just apologizing for not making you a lich, and then they killed you. Somebody kill these birds for me. Right now. Thank you, Saradin. Well, Xavier, at least your death was not in vain. Also, your death was not permanent. You just lose some experience and some charisma. And it's not like you need your charisma anyway. You've got tons of it. Actually, you didn't. I thought that you were supposed to lose charisma when you revived. Maybe you lose luck when you die or something like that. I thought there was some detriment to actually being dead. Other than the money. Alright, let's think about this. That? Right, we can handle that again if... I actually don't have anyone that can do... I don't think anyone... No, if I equipped Xavier with a white elemental weapon, he could kill the ghost. He's the only one, though, that does, like, a physical attack that would be different based on what you equipped, your weapon. That still does way too much damage. I'm not impressed. Ah well. If you die, you die. Should teach you to dodge better next time. Ah, you got him anyway. Good work. You got your revenge after all. Agility up. Not bad item. So that was Kai. Alright. Well, I would prefer to not lengthen this episode even longer than it's needed to be. The game is getting fairly... I wouldn't necessarily repetitive, but... Like, you know, we know what's going to happen by now. There's not a whole lot of surprises. Do I have any white weapons? Don't believe so. So who did I give last time... That... It's the Thunder Spear. Who did I just fight with that I ended up giving that white weapon? Didn't that just happen today? I'm sure I equipped the Mystic Staff on someone. My memory is shot. I don't even know where it went. Who was I using? They're all deployed. I didn't take anyone home yet. So where'd it go? Oh, maybe I gave it... Oh, yeah, okay. There it is. I gave it to Philip, the Tiger Man. Okay. We're gonna take that away. We can let him have something else. He can have a flame sword. That's fine. There you go, Philip. And then we're gonna take the Mystic Staff... Gonna give it to Xavier, who's going to very carefully move to the front row, which is fine. There we go. And now he's gonna be able to kill that ghost, as long as he doesn't miss. Doesn't matter what I focus on here, it's all gonna be the same. Alright. It's all up to you, Xavier. You just gotta kill that ghost. Just kill the ghost. There you go! Good work! Excellent! Didn't get you any alignment, sorry. Alright. Now this group is getting pretty highly leveled. I don't really want them to kill everything. Wouldn't be bad for Geist to get some levels up. I'm gonna send him kinda over this way out of the way a little bit. We're probably gonna have to use another moonbeam. That's okay. What do we got over here? We got the Gold Dragon Armada. Deneb could probably deal with it. Aisha might be a well. Be tough. Considering... I feel like there's a lot of stuff on the west side here. West side. So let's send some more towards the east side. And and that'll hold off that one. And then that way I can leave Deneb to go continue her journey of liberation. Alright, let's continue! Pretend there was an episode end there. That's a good point for episode end. Oh, looks like Deneb's gonna catch them anyway. That's fine. I'll be surprised if you really wipe them out. It's more likely they will kill the monk by accident. I'm gonna do an old trick that I haven't really had to show on camera in a while. But as long as you don't kill anything, they won't run away generally. So if you know they're gonna heal, or if you know you're gonna kill them all, well, I said usually. Sometimes they get smart and change their plan, but I was hoping that what would happen is that that unit would keep fighting, keep moving towards me, and now that she was almost dead, we'd have a better chance of wiping them out completely. But that's one of the reasons I don't use that trick very often, is it doesn't always work. Alright, Geist. Yeah, we're gonna have to change the time of day. Always a good plan to have all these moon. I don't actually think, for all the tricks that I normally use that I'm not showing you guys, well, I've shown you most of them, but all of the tricks that I normally use when I'm playing this game, I don't think I've ever taken advantage of the moon and sunbeams and the boots and the bells as often as I have on this Let's Play. I think it's because it saves time, and when I'm making a recording, trying to make reasonably length episodes and get things done for entertainment's sake to some degree, being able to speed things up is really, really nice. I mean, it's not just the frame skip, but less having to click stuff and move people around. It's good. That evil ring is not terrible. It's not terrible indeed. I think the sorceress should be able to get the final kill here. Alright. Yeah. Not too tough. This is gonna be... another phantom! So many phantoms! Well, this time we don't have it, right? I moved it. Am I gonna switch it back right away? Fine. Oops. Well, that's fine. I'll give the kooky staff back to Xavier, if that's what he used to have. I don't even remember. You can have it. And then I'll give the mystic staff to... let's give it to the other Tiger Man this time. Idjared, you can have it now. That one token enemy ghost that just messes everything up. Well, there. Idjarin seems to be better than his buddy. No misses here. Alright! The Vampire Brigade continues to be powerful. Hey! I mean, those are pretty good. I'm not going to make any more princesses. I think we've already got more than our fair share. But yeah, honestly, if every unit had a princess, it probably would be stronger. But no. That's just too much. I've had too good luck for this Let's Play to keep making more princesses. I would probably turn next my, whatever the hero is in my unit, I forget her name, Roni maybe? She's a muse right now. Probably turn her into a princess and she'd be... freaking insane. Anyway, this battle is not going to go well for them. I can just tell. Is it? I know Norn. I've been trying to turn enemy clerics into, hero clerics into princesses. Roni would also make a very good princess with all that intelligence. Like, she's a great muse, don't get me wrong. It's really the female characters that start as a shaman or a monk. Most of that intelligence goes to waste on them, so it's much better switching them over to a muse if you don't have any crowns, or a princess if you've got crowns. Like Deneb and, whatever, all the other healers. Aisha. Was Aisha? No, it's... yeah, Aisha was one of them, yeah. There's a bunch like that. Alright, so what are we gonna do? We are chasing this one down pretty effectively. Deneb's probably gonna catch her. Aisha's just hanging out in the water. Yeah, Aisha was like one of the healers. She's got like hero statted princess, which is pretty insane. Stabbity stabbity Sandy. forget to check the stats of these people every now and then, just to see if they're... how they're looking. I guess we just push forward. Kid, you're gonna head up here? Actually, it's kind of incorrect. Because I'm planning on fighting mostly at night, put him there, and then I can send Eric to the front side, the forward-facing side of the city. And we'll send Geist across, and we'll send Saradin up along the river. That should be pretty good. Oh, that one must be a flyer, hey? It's moving pretty quickly, whoever it is. Yeah, wyverns. Well, kid, I don't know if you're going to be able to beat the wyverns, but I'll give you a chance. I'll give you a chance, kid. I'll give you a chance. This unit... I really thought that this would be a good unit when we started out the game. But they're... This is my new weakest unit, definitely. I need to try them during the daytime. But... I mean, this is just pathetic. I'd like to get one heal in and then we'll run. Would have been better to get that heal in. Alright, let's get out of there. Just not terribly impressed with the damage these samurai can turn to dish out. You know, three attacks isn't bad, but three attacks that do like 10 damage, I mean, it's not gonna do anything. Luckily, we've got Eric here, slowly swimming across the channel. Alright, you can cover this, right? Even in the water? Yeah. Yeah, I'll try not to give up on Kid's Samurai completely until I get to see him during a daylight fight to see if his damage scales enough. But, he's starting to get put on the bad list. It's a slow process. You know, I didn't get rid of Aldrich and Indy for a very long time. But, and the same thing with, like, the first one was the dog unit with Dino. And he was the one that I'm like, man, this is just not gonna work. But, you know, I try them out, I think, for a reasonable amount of time before I finally give up on them. Alright, so, yeah, the healer's gonna be dead. The question is, can we do enough damage to kill the dragons before the end of the round? I might want to use an Emperor... No, I'll be good. I was thinking I might need an Emperor's card. Nope, forget that. How is Deneb's alignment still pretty good? 0, 0, pretty good. Alright, we're still at about 50-50 for average alignment. So we shouldn't be losing reputation for liberating with her. Should probably just maintain it about. Anyway, we've liberated Dant Castle. Dat Castle has been Dat liberated. That's not so good. The High Monk Randalls is said to have received powerful black magic from Rashidi. He claims to be a man of the temples, and yet he uses black magic and consorts with an evil mage Rashidi. Is anyone surprised at this point that this guy is evil? Also, are we done? We might be done, guys. You've liberated Ryagam. That's an interesting one. Alright, I don't mind one of those. I'll even keep that. I heard that one of the four divas, General Luvalon, is in Salarn Castle. Luvalon must have been called here by the High Monk. So I think the idea here is no matter which route we took into the Empire, you're going to have to fight one of the divas. We'll fight them both. Well, this is a little bit quicker than I was thinking. I guess we had to fight a lot, but we are basically at the end of this one. Looks like they don't have any more units left. So, in this situation... I want to liberate all the cities. I have to liberate all the cities to get all the dialogue. We're not skipping and just rushing to the boss, because there could be some cool stuff that you guys don't know about, and I probably have forgotten about, so we'll have to liberate everything. I don't need to get all the treasure right now, but I do need to liberate everything. So let's use some bells here. Send people home that are in the way. might deploy a flyer or something to speed this up too. I guess I should decide who's gonna actually fight this guy. I don't think there's any custom dialogue with him, no matter who we send. No one has a history. So, I mean, we could use, like, Eric and Geist. What does he have? It's all evil units. So he would prefer to fight during the night. So we should send a high alignment daytime unit. I'll tell you what. I'm gonna try to let Kid fight the boss during the daytime. I don't know if it's gonna work. I've probably got enough tarot cards to carry him either way, but that will give me a reasonable judge of how strong he is. So we'll do that. All right, so what am I missing? We've got at least two cities. There's an invisible city there. Oh, there's an invisible city down here. Okay, hold on. Just so that we can get all the dialogue out of the way. You need to head down somewhere in here, I think. Maybe this, probably right here. Liberated a temple! Liberation indeed. World card! Well, it's a little bit too late for that, unfortunately. Do I have lots of world cards? Yeah, three is enough. Definitely like having a few of those for emergencies, though. And an item! A mystic hat! It's not that mystical. It's just a hat. Randall's is an embarrassment to the name of the temples. He declares a tax for the blessing of the gods, a tax for the blah blah, we've done this already. His very existence is blasphemy. Please do something about him. Like, kill him? Is killing something that a noble warrior would do? I don't know, guys. Temple City Jabala. Yay, Jabala. I like those fool cards too. That does mean plus one luck for everyone deployed, which is really good. I heard that Randall's is terrified that the rebels came here. It seems he hasn't had a good night's sleep ever since the fall of Zenobia. Well, at least it helped him with his diet. Ha ha ha. Yeah, fat jokes, I guess. All right, so we need to go to this island for another city. Guy missed his CD. Okay, so maybe it's like... Well, it could just be a little bit south of him. Nope. Okay, it could be west of him. This seemed like a little bit too narrow, though. Nope. Alright, we found ourselves a temple. The Magician! Sure, magic's fun. I hear that the witch who lives in Ramato came from the Sky Islands. As a matter of fact, that man Bolterano in Alagoya used to say the same thing. Where is Alagoya? Far to the east in the Zenobia district. I'm sure we've talked to him before. Alright, there's treasure, temples. Did I liberate this one on the way through ever? I feel like I might have skipped it. Base. There should be something here, too, actually. Libation. Oh, you know what I should do, also? Before we have to pay money, I should scale the time back a little bit. Randall's calls himself the Grand Monk, but he's actually just a merchant. He used the confusion brought on by the war to buy that position from the Empire. Like they say, the worse someone becomes, the better he tries to look. I haven't heard that one exactly, but I'll take your word for it. Oh, I didn't click it in time. Oh, well. So we didn't make optimal amounts of money for this episode. That's fine. Don't stress your little heart about it. There's going to be some treasure down in here. It's going to take a while to get to that island. Okay, yeah, we skipped that one, I guess, sort of by accident. So now we've liberated it properly. Oh, good. Now we get the moon card. And an item! The Flame Bracelet. It burns to the touch. Yeah, I think we've read this before. When I think of a man like that as High Monk, it makes me so mad I could spit. That's not terribly mad, is it? It's just a little bit upset. Okay, I think we're about done. We've got those two cities. I know I went to that temple. There's treasure here, there's treasure there. There's just one city on that island left. And then we'll have all the cities. Okay. So what I will do is, I still want to try with Kid, but I might leave Deneb out there in case Kid's not enough. Because I'm not sure if he's going to be strong enough for what is needed. I don't even know if he's going to be able to kill this mermaid. He's going to lose to a mermaid, guys. Well, at least we're not missing every attack. Alright, that'll kill it. Good work, Kid! You killed a fish girl! And you got another bell. The bell means you should go home. Apparently. Okay, Denim needs to keep going. I just didn't want her to accidentally run into the boss. Somewhere down here is where the treasure is. I might as well get it while we're here. There we go. Maybe it'll be really valuable for the boss fight. Demons? Ooh, I've got too much stuff! Oh no! Oh boy. Well, what's my worst armor right now? That's probably garbage. We'll just get rid of that. So, yeah, I need to clean up my inventory after this fight. Well, it's actually not a staff at all. It's a demon hammer. It might do black damage. It's possible. So sorting them gave me a couple slots. I just got too much armor not equipped, basically, and some weapons. I've actually got, at this point, probably more weapons and armor than I can even equip to all my guys. So I kind of need to go through and go, oh, that's better than something we've got equipped, trade, and then just throw the other stuff away. Because it's just, you know, I've got a lot of units, but they've already, almost all of them have something equipped. Almost every single one. Alright, let's speed this along. I've still got lots to do this episode. Alright. I'm kind of hoping he'd get a level up here before he has to fight the boss. Alright, it was just a temple after all. I thought it might have been a city, but turns out it was just a temple. And anything good? No. The answer is no. That's what I get for swimming over here. But we do get an item! We get an ice sword. It's actually like maybe ice claws, I think. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I get you. I hear ya. So, what is this ice claw? Ice scimitar, sorry, but it is one of the worst weapons in the game. I mean, it probably adds ice elemental, but other than that, it's pretty terrible. Alright, so we've been to all the cities. We don't have all the treasure yet, but we'll do that when we come back. We'll speed this up. That didn't take too long. That didn't take too long at all with super speed. Don't worry, guys, I'm not going to forget to heal him up. Alright, Kid, I'm counting on you. I will use at least one tarot card to give you a better chance. But, you know, you've got to do some damage yourself to really prove that you're worth the slot in the arm here. Alright, here you go, buddy. You know what to do. You gotta fight it out.
So you've made it here. You think that you could defeat the great Randells? If you kill me, Rashidi will be very displeased. Lulon, how could you leave me at a time like this? At least I have the power of Rashidi has given me.
Yeah, we'll see about that. So, it's a boss. It's not a very intimidating boss. He looks a little bit like the Divas. Let's go with... lots of evil people. Let's go with Justice. No, Judgment. Yeah, Judgment should be white. Justice is ice. It's got the ice in the name, that's how you know. Uh-oh, Nightmare! That wasn't that bad. Looked kind of fun. Alright, let's, concerned we're not going to get to the boss in a reasonable... well, we got four Emperor cards. Okay, we'll go with the Emperor cards. Tactics, strong though. Do lots of damage. That's not as much as I was hoping. They're probably gonna kill my alchemist, aren't they? Alright, Kid, do it! That's a facepalm right there. So the samurais. The amazing samurai masters. Actually, I don't think they're called samurai masters. They're like Kenshin or something now. They used to be, though. Well, okay, if you hit, you do good damage. Uh-oh, it's gonna kill somebody. Somebody is dead. Why? Hit him. You know, I can use Emperor cards, but we're not gonna be able to kill him anyway. You failed me. Unless I just use tarot cards to kill all the enemies, this is not gonna work. You deserve it. You just also deserved it. Good. That serves you right. You and your kind are not welcome here anymore. Sorry, kid, but your units might not have another chance after that performance. I mean, yeah, we're like... Okay, Randall's is pretty high level, but we're only one level behind the evil ones. And I know the evil ones aren't that good, because I have one. I've had four, and they were all terrible. Deneb, you're at proper HP, right? Okay. Alright, Deneb, show these punks how it's done. You've got, like, evil units, and you're still going to fight fine during the day. I know you're going to be fine. I'm not even going to use any magic. You'll be fine. Don't worry about it. It's just Phantom. It's not going to hurt. Hurt my feelings. That's all. Did he dodge the starlight? You can't dodge stars. At least you can dodge the lightning. Haha, nice try. That's how you punch. Alright. You know what to do. Murder this fool. Two more magic attacks and three physical attacks. Ha! He just misses. Yeah, look at this. This is how you fight. Kid, I don't know what's wrong with you guys. This is easy. You don't need tarot cards. Sure, we miss sometimes, but make sure you hit the time after you miss. And then you just punch him in the face. This big, stupid, fat face, and he dies. Alright, well, Deneb's unit's definitely stronger than Kid's. Probably by a large margin. Well, we've now liberated Salami. Salarn, it's just a slang for salami. Everyone's happy, there's fireworks. Huzzah. Sorry, kid, but I'm not probably going to take you out much anymore. I'm trying to use all the units, but like right now I'm really tempted to cut out Indy and the Shinobi. You know, actually, I don't feel bad. I've shown them off. I've brought them to the end game. We're at the end phase where everyone's kind of got the best promotions. And they suck. So we're going to cut them from the team probably at the end of the episode. I'll do it in between. And the ninja and the evil one and the devil, they're just going to fly away and you'll never see them again. And the army will be better for it. So we'll deal with that later. It's been a pretty long episode, but we'll go back for the treasure and the chit-chat just to make sure we've not forgotten about it. Then next episode, well, you can probably spend the entire time doing the side quest, but yeah, let's see. Anyway, Guy, you're a good guy. You are going to be a good guy that finds me some treasure. Let's see. Somewhere like... Maybe here? Hard to say for sure. And then Vanilla, you're very plain. We're going to send you... Well, we have to revisit all the places anyway. And I only have the two... I've only got the two high sky. I could send Canopus out, but it'll be okay. I'll do some walking myself. I've been sitting in my castle all day. I needed some exercise. May the god... Yeah, I feel like we're going to get that a lot today. We're in, like, temple district. Everyone's going to talk about the gods and such and such. Alright, there was no treasure there. Yeah. The gods don't even follow us. We're the ones that have to go talk to the gods up in the sky ourselves. They don't come visit us. We've got to go find them. And then we have to get the treasure for them to even like us. Somewhere around here, though, I kid you not. Have you heard of the Zenobian Queen Florin? No, I haven't. Everyone said that she was killed along with King Gran 25 years ago. Oh. But apparently that's not true. I heard that she is being held in Fort Shulamana In Fort La Milana to the southwest. So if the old queen is alive, I feel like Tristan might want to go have a talk. He might be interested. Why am I having such a hard time here? Somewhere, just this area of the map. It's gotta be some treasure. Probably, like, totally the wrong place. Actually, it's not this close to the edge. It's probably maybe up here. Probably, maybe, definitely, sort of. Could be. Yeah, gods. I've had that talk already. Next. Guy has still not found anything good. Guy! You're supposed to find us the treasure. Ah, there you go.
Find it.
Thanks, guy. You're not my buddy, pal. And it's... Oh, this is actually going to be difficult. We're not going to have enough room for all this armor. We sincerely thank you for restoring the good name of the temples. Yeah, that's me. Yeah, we're out of space again. So... A terrible ice scimitar. We're gonna sell a couple things just quickly here. It's a weapon, but it's not a good weapon. And just physical resistance, not enough. Let's just get rid of a couple more quick. Like, a fire shield isn't bad, but armor is not my main priority mostly. Power shield gives a lot of physical resistance, but I mean, it's just physical resistance. Doesn't make much difference. The spiky shield is gone. The Royal Hat. White resistance. Like, this is actually pretty good for, like, a zombie dragon or a lich or something, but, eh. I say pretty good. Even that's a bit of a stretch. It's possibly vaguely useful. I didn't even look at that one. Look, armor is just not very good in this game, okay? We had to talk about it earlier. The whole stat is based on a 255 integer. 0 to 255. I think if you get to 255, you might resist all the damage, like, sort of scale 0 to 255 the same you'd scale 0 to 100% resistance. Oh, int will keep. Okay. We'll stop selling stuff at that point. But, you know, plus 5 or 10 to a various element is just not going to do anything, really. You're never going to be able to hardly tell the difference. We'll just send myself up this way first. Alright, so Guy got the treasure. Now Guy's got to go visit these cities to the west. Thanks, Guy. You're a good buddy, pal. Did I forget about somebody that's supposed to be moving? No. Yeah, gods. I'm sure there's someone around here that wants to talk. Probably on the island to the east. Thanks for restoring the name of the temples. At least we haven't had, like, a totally... dot 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 vis- oh wait, there's a treasure to the east of this temple and I've missed it somewhere in here. May the gods follow you on your journey. I know I've said it before, but it would be really nice if the cities had more than like two dialogues. It could be just north of this river. It's hard to tell on my map. Still haven't seen any. It's supposed to be like northwest of this city and east of the temple. Hey, let me give you this sword, Sigmund! It was forged by the thunder god Tool? So, we actually had a small discussion about this in the comments. When I first picked up my first Sigmund sword, which I've got two of now, I said, I'm pretty sure this is from some sort of lore. Yeah, there's some North lore about killing some dragons in some stuff with some of the gods. I don't think it was Tool, though. It may have been Odin or Thor, but I don't think it was Tool that forged it. The god Tool, god of... swords, I guess. Like I said, there's been a lot of retranslations of this. Forged by Tool in the fires of biscuits. Just random words, you know. So I'm still not finding that. Maybe there isn't any treasure here. Maybe I'm crazy. One of the four divas, General Luvalon, was at Salarn recently. It seems that he went to Kulin to avoid your arrival. Luvalon may also be going to Kulin to look for the Grail. It's possible. Maybe he's scared of us. Alright, Guy is not finding a lot of treasure. And Vanilla is not moving very much, so let's get this going. This game on the road. Show on the road. Let's get this, you know. This ramble on the bramble. That's what I'm going to start calling him. Okay, well, I've flown around there a lot and I haven't seen anything, so if I don't find any treasure pretty soon, I'm just going to say the map is lying and then we'll move along. Oh, also. Ha! Caught it in time. We can save some money here. Don't pay upkeep, just pay a moonbeam. Alright, one more pass to the east here. If I don't find it, then I quit. I quit looking for it. I don't quit that's playing, don't worry. I've been attacked probably by a mermaid. Ah, we'll kill it, I guess. I don't really need the XP, but... You mess with me in my house, you get bolted. And blasted with ice, little white balls. Three white balls, don't judge me. Alright. One less mermaid to worry about. And we did find the buried treasure. It's not very northwest of that city, is it? Are you kidding me? They're just throwing these up. So the city where they happen to have the legendary Sigmund blade. Here. It was forged at Tool. We've got hundreds of them. Just one lying outside the city if you want it. It's great. I mean, it's a really good sword. Oh, gee whiz. All right, well, let's finish this up. It's not going to get any better than that today. Oh, I can't do any voices. I can't. Oh, I got to breathe. I've been waiting a long time for you to come. That's what she said. Just as Philana predicted, you, Blue, have been declared a true hero. Therefore, I must give you this gem of truth. Take all three gems of Philana to the shrine. Her shrine. Philana's shrine. Alright, I'm glad I made room in my inventory. Because now, somewhere... Oh, true gem? You can't just hold it up in the air and do something. Do 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 do. Now we've got three jewels of Philana and three swords of Sigmund and three jewels of Philana. You know, why not? That's good. I think I'm gonna save the visit to Philana for next episode. It's just too much. Alright, now there is buried treasure up here. We may have gotten it randomly. I'm not 100% sure if I picked this one up. Nope. We walked right by this a couple times, but now we got it for real. The Hulu sword. It's a hula hoop. It's not really a sword. I think it's okay, though, isn't it? It's pretty good. It's no Sigmund. But, I'll handle it. There should be one over here as well we must have missed. And then one more after that. Actually, we may have gotten this again because we kind of went through this area. Or it could be down this way. You never know. My map's not that amazing. It is supposed to be somewhat northwest of that city down there. Try to explain. We've only got like one more city to visit, then we'll visit all the cities, I think. I didn't expect much, but had to try. So I think once Vanilla gets to that last city, we'll have been everywhere. So, is there going to be treasure below this channel? Beyond here lies the Shrine of Kulin. It's said that King Gran found the Grail at that shrine. At least one of the cities talked about it. Thank you. Alright, we're going to send you... Somewhere in here. Maybe this looks suspicious. Alright, so there's kind of like a triangle of buried treasure. That one in the middle of the mountains is probably one. The one to the southwest we already got. And the one to the southeast, maybe we already got. Maybe I've missed it. I don't know. Or maybe it's like right there. Oh, I was trying to avoid those. Oh, well. I think... Didn't we get one treasure during our battle? I think I might have already gotten it then. Yeah, we found... That was the north point of the triangle. And it's a thunder... bracelet or glove? Thunder glove. Nope! It's a thunder club. It looks really bad. Because I think that counts as armor, even though it says it's a club. It's really a glove. I think the pictures are more correct than the translation. Like, you know, the one that says it's a claw? I think it's really just a sword. But anyway, I think we're probably done here. I'll have one more look at the southeast point of my triangle to see if I can find that treasure. So, Vanilla's at the north point. That gap to the west of the mountains is the east, is the western point. The eastern point is supposed to be a little bit further north than where this treasure was. Like, it's not straight east. It's up a bit. So it was probably in here, and we probably already got it. Yeah. All right. You could always rewind the footage for you guys. Just go back and look. But I bet you we got it. So I think we've got all the treasure. We've got the 3 jewels of Phalana, which means now we're going to have to go talk to Phalana back in Shangri-La and see what she has to say. There's something about this... Holy Grail, we might have to go do that too, but maybe we'll go find the mystic the Zodiac Stones first. Or maybe we'll have to get all the mystic treasures first. I forget the order. We'll figure it out, guys. It's either next episode or after the Shrine of Kulin that we'll be able to go for the Zodiac Stones, I think. I'll double check anyway. So thanks for watching, folks. Hope you have enjoyed. I am likely to cut some people out because I think I've come to a decision on, like, I have shown off Shinobi. They're not good. I have shown off Devils. They're really not good enough. Like, one AoE black magic is kind of the same as what we're getting from vampires, except the vampires are very resistant and they do a lot more damage. And if I put them in the front row, they can steal HP away. Whereas the Devil, if you put him in the front row, he's just nothing. So they seem pretty bad. I will keep, you know, I've got a hero angel, so we'll keep her around. And I might also cut back on the paladin. So, like, right now we've got 16 total units. I might try to carve that down to, like, 14 by getting rid of some samurai. I'll keep maybe one samurai, but if I move Debonair and Tristan around, cut out a couple people, you know, I've got a lot of paladins and stuff I don't necessarily need. I guess some of you guys might be named, but, like, Vader and Vega are okay, but they're not going to be much better than Buster and Axe, although they have amazing names. Should have given Axe an Axe. That would have been pretty good. Anyway, time to end the episode. That's as far as I go for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed, and have a great day.